Sealteam 6 and what their families are alleging. What their families are alleging now in a press conference that we couldn't find coverage anywhere yesterday afternoon at 5 o'clock. I believe it was Breitbart and The Blaze. Those are the only ones covering this. And it's an amazing thing. You have Sealteam 6 members. Now, these are the ones who went in and killed Osama bin Laden. These are the best and the bravest. Their families, if you remember, there was a helicopter crash, and the helicopter crash killed, what was it, 21?
20 SEALs and six others, was it?
Yeah, it was bad. And it was a very, very dark day for America. Well, there was a funeral. Now, I believe there are more facts to come out. I have spoken to a few of the people involved, and there are some pretty shocking facts that I don't know why they have not been released yet, but maybe it's because nobody's paying attention to the facts that they are releasing. I think you need to. Our government insisted that a Muslim cleric be there for the blessing of the bodies. So first, a pastor gets up, and he starts to pray in English. And he's praying in English, and he is saying that, you know, bless these, welcome them home, you know, Lord, these valiant soldiers, etc., etc. Then the Muslim cleric starts to sing his prayer. Now, the families wanted to have this translated, because they didn't want the Muslim cleric there. They're like, why is the Muslim cleric here? And one of the members of the family said, could we have this translated, please? And so they went and they took it to a certified translator. And they weren't happy with what this cleric was singing. Now, he's singing something right out of the Quran. But you tell me if this is something... Why is our government insisting that this is being done? And you tell me that this guy didn't damn the souls of all of those Navy SEALs. Listen to this. You have it, Pat? Now, we're going to have to... We're playing it here, but I'm going to translate it. It says, Amen, I shelter in Allah from the devil who has been cast with stones, in the name of Allah, the merciful forgiver. The companions of the fire, meaning the sinners and the infidels, who are fodder for hellfire. It's important, because if you're not a Muslim, you're an infidel. He says, those sinners are not equal with the companions of heaven. So in other words, if you're not Muslim, you're not going to heaven. The companions of heaven, the Muslims, are the winners. He says, had we sent this Quran to a mountain, you would have seen the mountain prostrated in the fear of Allah. Now, this part in the Quran mocks the God of Moses. It's important that you understand, the God of Abraham is not the God the Muslims follow. It is the split of the two sons. It is not the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It is the God of Abraham, Ishmael. So it splits. The examples we present to the people, so they would think, which means basically so they will repent and convert to Islam. Blessings to your God Allah, the God of glory, and peace be upon the messengers, the prophets, and thanks be to Allah, the Lord of both the universe, mankind, and jinn. Now, for some reason, these families have a problem with that. Now, you can read it two ways. You can read it as a believer. You can read it as somebody who says, they mean every word that they say. I know if I go to a preacher and I am asking him to say a prayer, I know that whatever he says at the funeral, he means every word, or at least I do. I mean every word that would be out of his mouth. And what this scripture is saying is, if you are not Muslim, these companions of the Muslims are not equal. So these guys who died here are not going to heaven. They will not go, and it's a warning to convert.
He's essentially damning them.
Yes,
right,
he's warning, he's saying, I'm lifting up my voice, that the infidels will not go to heaven. They are not the same, they are not equals, and I am lifting up my voice to say, convert.
I mean, what a weird... Why did they insist on this to begin with? Unless somebody... Now, this is the funeral for these families. The soldiers aren't there anymore. The families are. Did they request?
No, they didn't want
anyone?
They didn't want it.
Why would you force that on them? I don't understand it. Is it fair to equate this to any other enemy we've had in history? Like World War II? In the extreme... Islamists would maybe be compared to Nazis. And then the imam might be one of the German people. Well, our beef wasn't with the German people, just as our beef isn't with Islam. But you still wouldn't do that. Would you? Would you invite...
No, you would not. You
would
not
invite a German pastor to pray over American soldiers killed by Nazis?
Hang on just a second.
In German...
Hold on just a second.